Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is LeSquatch and welcome back to Sky Factory 3. And it has been a really long time since I last recorded on here, so forgive me if I'm a bit rusty. As you might be able to tell by the top left, it's day 3531, which is a little bit later than our previous episode. Excuse me. But I've done a few things since then. So I've been breeding chickens, and I've built a farming station. So let's go over here. This farming station has been really useful because it's enabled me to auto-harvest wheat and seeds whilst I've been offline, and I've been able to then breed up the chickens pretty quickly. And I built these nesting pens because I'm trying to reduce the number of chickens, mainly because of noise, but also because of entity lag. And I'm concerned that I have way too many chickens here. In fact, I've got 280 entities in the immediate vicinity, which is not good. I've put three of each because I thought that's probably realistically that's enough, like we don't need any more, and I'll probably kill the rest of these. But I'm still in the process of breeding cobalt chickens. I've won, but they're very slow. I think next egg, the maximum was 99 minutes, so it's very, very slow, and I've only been able to get the one so far. So I've just been keeping breeding over and over again. Oh, excuse me. I still, like, even though this is... Come breed, there we go. Even though this is, like, 2 weeks, maybe, after I... Oh, yes, finally got a second one. Yes, good. We can start our cobalt chicken society. But yeah, it's been about 2 weeks since I last recorded, and that's when I was really ill, and I had proper man flu, which is a medical thing, I swear. And I was really ill and sneezing and coughing and all that sort of stuff, and sputtering. And I'm still, like, having the side effects of that. But I'm almost back to normal, like way, way better than I used to be. So I have this to-do list here. So I want to transfer these, or transform these, into a colossal chest, because I think it'd be way cooler, and I've never used that mod before. I think it's about time we build a factory that can house all of these things. They're not just out in the open, and they're not small and restricted. We need to improve our power, and I've done a little bit on that. And we need to start to make refined storage drives. And I have made this already. I put a crafting recipe in, so I just crafted it. And I got up to 1064K discs. But I kind of want to try this colossal chest thing first, because I think it would be pretty, pretty cool. And actually, we need to put in the recipes for the diamond ones, so I only put in the wooden ones. But yeah, diamond one would be pretty sweet. How much is this going to cost? Not too bad. I mean, how many diamonds do we have? I mean, it's going to be ridiculous. Yeah, 114,000. I think we can probably afford a diamond colossal chest. But before I put in those recipes, because I'll go and do that between these two cuts, I want to show you this new build. This is going to be the factory, and I've designed it so that it covers no more than four chunks. So the middle is an even build, which I haven't done in years, so it's going to be quite interesting to design this place and keep it symmetrical and neat. But yeah, it's four chunks in total, so I'm hoping that we then can eventually move all of our machinery into these four chunks and only chunk load these and not chunk load anything else. Because then that means that we're not straining the server too much with the stuff that we're trying to load. So this is just the bare bones of it. Let's take the chunk borders off. There'll be, I'll take down this storage, this whole storage thing is going to go into the colossal chests, I think. Or maybe I'll have this anyway because we need an overflow. Or maybe use the redstone, refined storage drives plus a trash can. I don't know, I haven't decided that far yet. But I want to use a variety of storage things to keep this interesting. But yeah, there's a nice open space. We can put rooms in. I probably won't, to be honest. Probably just make an open plan. But I might put rooms in, I'm not entirely sure. Maybe if I have a second story, then I'll put rooms in. But I'm really bad at ceilings. It's my weakness in Minecraft. But I've got a lower floor here where we can fiddle around with all the pipes and wires, and there's enough room. So yeah. And also I transferred all of these from the extra utilities devices over to the Ender IO ones. And I've built one upgraded lava generator Mark II, which I didn't realize, but it does 64 RF per tick. But that makes sense because its recipe is 8 of these lava generators. So now, because I had a bit of a power problem, so I had to do it, like, immediately. Now we're generating a nice amount of RF. Like, it's enough for our needs. It's not, like, super crazy that we need, what's it called? The, big reactors, or extreme reactors, what's it called? Extreme. Yeah, it's in there. What was that big then? That big Oh, it's just, it comes up with that anyway. Oh, interesting. Okay, fine. Both of those ats work. I also need to put in a mob trap for Enderman, because they keep teleporting, because I put witch water in here. I can't remember if I mentioned that last time, I can't remember if I did it last time, but I put witch water in there and expanded the mob farm a little bit. And what that does is when zombies... Well, when villagers go in, they turn into witches. When spiders go in, they turn into cave spiders. Maybe we'll see something here. I don't think it affects zombies or the other NPCs. But when a skeleton goes in, well, you might see, yeah, see it turns black? Might see it better there. Yep, it turns into a wither skeleton. So in doing that, we've been able to get 458 wither skulls, loads of wither dust, and as many drops of evil as we will ever need. And in doing so, I made a cursed lasso. So I have that. I think I've got the golden lasso, yeah, which has a bat in it. So if we wanted to, and I think I will at some point, we could, with those lassos, make the ring. But we don't really have any of this stuff. We need... Oh, that's not too bad, actually. No, I didn't. Okay, anyway. So I'm going to put in the recipes for the colossal chest. I'm also going to... Because we have those uranium chickens now, the green ones, up there, in this row here. They're producing uranium, and you can form those into blocks. And they actually provide, if we can see it here... on the crucible, 20 times the speed of it melting lava and melting a cobble as opposed to 3 times with just lava. So how many more do we need? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, and then 11, because I've only got 3 under there. So we look for uranium, take out 11 blocks, and then we can finally upgrade our power supply to something that we can actually be using, because as it stands, it's pretty slow. I mean, even with all these crucibles, it's pretty slow. But hopefully this will be the end of our power woes. Can I fit this in there? I can. Good. So we now have it all upgraded to 20 times the speed. And are we going to notice any immediate effects? I mean, these were already full anyway. So I think what we were doing before did actually suffice. And this has not changed. But I think it's because this is being throttled by the power cables. But I actually have made a load of these top tier energy conduits, because I had the recipe for it. So I was like, why not? So I think it's probably about time we upgrade this sort of thing. And how are we going to do this without messing up our entire system? That is a question I will leave for later. But right now I will put in those colossal chests recipes. I probably need to make another one of these crafters. Yep. Several more of those crafters, because we've run out of space. So I will go and do that. Can I make 10? I can make 10. I'll go and do that, and I will be right back. So there are a few other things that I've been meaning to do for a very long time. He says at 15 FPS. Holy, what's going on? Okay, first of all, there's a lot of Endermen around. It's probably not helping anything. But why am I going to be 15 FPS? It's crazy. I haven't changed anything. I made some of these colossal chest cores at walls. Actually, talking about that, I actually did manage to make 64 cores by mistake, because I clicked on the wrong thing. Whoopsies. Why are you, like, full of something? Why is the FPS so bad? Also, this keeps catching fire. I swear our base just gets struck by lightning. And, yeah, stuff burns. Which is rather annoying. One sec. Okay, just reloaded the chunks. That seemed to have fixed the issue. It's not 15 FPS anymore. But we need to be stronger. Because I've been trying to kill these Endermen who pop out. And they do a lot of damage to me. And I'm, like, I'm almost near death by the time I just kill one of them. So there are two things. We need better armor. That wasn't too bad. We need better armor and we need better weapons. So I think there's obsidian armor. Yes, there is. So we need... what do we currently have? We have an obsidian helmet. We need the pants. Oh, we could do the dark armor. That's probably better. Can I make this tougher? I probably should start to invest in the dark armor. Oh! Okay, turns out I already made it ahead of time. I'd forgotten about that. So if we get rid of this and then put this on, how much armor do we have? Is that any greater than what we had already? No, it's exactly the same. Okay, but we can't fly. So I'll put that on and these on. And we get more armor. Okay, that's good. So the jetpack's better armor than the dark chest piece, at least without any of the upgrades. But I think the upgrades wouldn't do much. Like, it would take energy away instead of durability if we added the Vibrant Crystal, like this boots. So it says full damage negated when empowered, but 70% damage absorbed by power. And if we upgraded that, then we'll get better. So what can we do for legs? We don't know... Oh, we can't see it unless we have the power stuff on it. Night vision would be useful. But yeah, let's try and take on... I wonder if we can try that as well. Let's try and take on an Enderman. How much damage does he do? Half a heart. And he can't hit me. Half a heart. Okay, I like this. This is a good setup. I will stick with this. Now I can actually fight things. Because eventually I want to fight the Wither. Ooh, and a compressed Enderman. Ooh. Yeah, these guys are going to be hard. This will be a real test of our metal and our dark steel. Get it? Probably not. Oh man, these guys have so much... These guys have more health or am I just missing? There we go. Now we have a bajillion Enderman. Luckily they're not all aggroed on me. I thought they would be. And they're all full health as well. This is probably a mistake. get in the water! Get in the water! Ah, come get me now, bitches. Yeah, that's right. Oh, okay, I thought they would teleport away. They just don't go in. Okay. That's an immediate solution to my problem. I was not aware of that. So if I look at you. All of you. We'll get you mad. You mad, bros. Mad bros. Yeah. You can't catch me. You can't touch me. Can't touch us. Oh yeah. Anyway, they seem to have not aggroed on me anymore, which is a bit weird. But I'm gonna see if we can enchant our jetpack. I don't think we can. No, I didn't think so. Can we use a book? Oh, I just tried to fly and I couldn't. Do I have any enchanted books? No, I don't. Okay. I don't think you can enchant this. If we do uses, we can change the particles, but seeing as we're always in, like, not F5 mode, then we never see that anyway. So, one thing I did realise is that this colossal chest is only odd numbers. So it's going to look really weird if I put it in the factory. Maybe I could put it off-center. That could be... Oops, sorry. That could be a potential solution. Put it in the corner. I suppose we could do, actually. Depends how it looks. Anyway, I'm going to stop babbling on. I'm going to build this. Probably... So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 by 7. I think that's probably decent. And then we're going to get like a load of massive space. Oh, hello. So I'm going to build this and I'll be right back. It's quite fun standing here watching the Enderman teleport around. And for some weird reason that I can't work out, they're not aggro on me. I can just walk up, look at them, you know, punch them. They just don't care at all. But I think this got something to do with me having 15 FPS again. But, oh, this is so choppy. I apologise. But I'll try and fix it. Anyway, in the meantime, what do you guys think of this location? I think it's okay. It's a 7x7, so it's quite tall. But it's got a walkway around the edge so we can put pipes and wires and stuff on it. And it's got stuff underneath. So if you right-click on this and it's not finished, it'll tell you what's wrong. So expected exactly one of Colossal Chest Core while zero were found. And I'm not entirely sure if you have to place this in a certain way, but I'll put it at the back just so that we don't accidentally break it. And I'm hoping that once we do this, yes. Okay, it is turned into a chest that's facing the wrong way. Why are you facing the wrong way? You're facing this way. Okay. Maybe then it needs to be at the front so that it faces the front? I'm not entirely sure. This is the first time I've ever done this. So apologies for newbie mistakes. Yeah, I guess that works. Can you interact with the chest call? Diamond Colossal Chest 7. I guess that means 7x7. Oh, now the... Wait. That's weird. The chest core doesn't render when you open the chest. Or when it's using its closing animation. That's so cool though. Exactly like a diamond chest. Nice. And this will have like a massive amount of storage. So what we need to do... I'll just make sure I don't have 15 FPS anymore. Okay, well, recycling my recording seems to have fixed it. I'm not entirely sure why that happened. I have no idea why that happens. But it does. So we'll live with it. So let's have an external storage and loads of cabling. And before I forget, We should probably chunk load this area. Claim chunks 19 of 50. Well, loaded chunks 19 of 50. Okay, I can have up to 50. So yeah, I'm trying to reduce the amount of strain I put on the server because I'm probably putting a lot on it doing what I'm doing. And you are poking through the floor. But I guess that's one way of figuring out where the things are. But just so that we have some platform to get over there, let's take some of you out. Oops, no, not you. And we should be able to build just a little bit over, further over into where we need to be. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Can we get a fifth one? Nope. But we can reach this. So if I break you, you're letting light through and I can't reach. Let's make sure everything is lit because, of course, this is being shielded by the factory itself. So mobs can spawn, which is not ideal. I don't want that to happen. I need to put a chest interface somewhere. And that somewhere's going to be here. Interface. So as long as you don't break the core, by the way, you won't need any of your items. Excel storage. Bam. Done. Okay. Now I can thread cabling. Can I reach that? Yes. Okay. I will probably put that along the side. By the way, I added these chains. Oh, I didn't add them. These were here already. I just haven't mentioned them. I thought it would be cool to make this platform look like it's being held up by that, and then somehow this is floating magically. I haven't really thought it through that much, to be honest. But I thought it would be, you know, some nice little extra kind of realistic, kind of cool-looking addition. That's horrible. And that's horrible as well. And I'm just going to go and bring this all the way back to the other one. Ah, before I do that, I almost forgot. I need to change the priority on this, which means I need more cobblestone. And I'm just going to have a little temporary plain cobblestone walkway. So that I'm... Whoop, I need like a better way of getting down here. I'm probably not... Oh my goodness. Right, down the stairs. Down the stairs. This is what they were for. So I need to build a little cobblestone jetty out to here so I can actually see what I'm doing. And we need to put this storage priority on 10. Yep. I've changed the other ones to be like 12, 11, 10 so that it doesn't just put everything in all the chests at the same time. But I think if having this as priority 10 will be good because we don't want any, we want everything to go in here anyway. So yeah, I will just connect this up to the other system. And what I also need to do is take away these storage devices, external storages, and then migrate all of this into there. And one other way I was thinking of doing that is with an ender chest. I've had the stuff in my inventory for a while, but I wanted to do it on camera with you guys because it's advancing our little area, so I thought we'd best do it. So I'm going to put diamond on it, even though I'm the only... Oh no, I'm not the only one on this server, but I'm the only one who's kind of recording. I don't know where I was going with that. I'm the only one on the server. I'm not the only one on the server, but I want to put diamond on it anyway. That's my reasoning, and I'm sticking with it. So now we've linked this pouch together, and we can start to put in our tools, which is actually what I wanted to use it for originally. But I think I'm going to use it to pull items into that big colossal chest, so I can just stand here and put all this in. So I'll hook that up as well. Let's just thread this through. And I'm using my favorite word, thread. How many times did I say it in the previous episode? Too many. And I have a feeling this is going to be in line with the chain, isn't it? Yes, of course it is. Oh, I'm so good. Aren't I the best? Oh, that's never going to change. That's that. That's here forever now. So get used to it. Oh, my goodness. It's so hard to judge when it's dark. And when you're trying to, like, put a really thin... long thin cable onto another long thing. I don't know where I was going with that. So now we have that links up, we should hopefully be getting some items going in there. So if we then take away all of this, oops, oh my goodness, I swear guys, this, I'm not usually this bad, I'm just out of practice. Okay, so hopefully now we should see all of the extra stuff that we have. Oh, why did I go downstairs? All the extra stuff that we have going there. Hello, Mr. Zombie. You shouldn't be there. should not be there. That means there's dark spaces around here, which I should light up because I don't want creepers to spawn and blow everything up. Is there anything in there yet? Yes, there's one potato. Success! Okay, the system works. So now we should be able to get everything in there. And we also want to feed in the stuff from the end chest. So let's pick this up. Slowest end chest pickup thing ever. And we also want to have another interface. I think probably for the sake of ease, just around the back. So again, you can break it, as long as you don't break the core. And I'm going to put the interface down like so. Put the end chest like that. And I need an item conduit. And I think the Ender IO conduits will link up with the colossal chest pretty easily. And then we can just feed all of our items in there very, very quickly and effortlessly. So let's try and do this. That can be extract, this can be insert, and I'll test it with the ender pouch. Actually, that's technically not the thing I wanted to go in there. But yeah, that works. So let's just empty our inventory of what's already in the system. And let's put stuff that's not already in the system in here. That can go in, sure. This stuff can go in. Don't need any signs anymore. Yeah, the only thing is it's a bit slow. So I'm probably going to need to put some of these item upgrades on them, which I don't have any of. So let's just make some. I probably didn't need that many, but I'm going to make that many anyway. And then I will empty all these chests out, feed them into there, get rid of these chests. I don't really know what I'm going to put there in its place, because I'm not going to move all this stuff yet. But yeah, I will do that, and I'll be right back. So, with this, it is done! All of the items have been put into this giant colossal diamond chest. Giant colossal? Sure. And we have... Oh my... Wow, okay. Can we sort? Yes, we can! Wow! Okay, I'm impressed now. So how many rows do we have? We have all of these items in here. And we've just maybe not even gone a millimeter down on the slider. We have so much space. Oh my god, that's ridiculous. So, yeah, we won't have any issues with space for a very, very, very long time. So yeah, that was pretty cool. So I think to end this episode, I'm going to add another recipe in here. And that is for reinforced glass from Tiny Regressions that is witherproof. So that can go in. And we have loads of wither skulls now from our mob farm. So, I think, to really finally finish off the glass. We should probably build... Sure, let's make that many. Let's build a wither cage that we can use to spawn in the wither and kill it. And we have smite 4 on our obsidian sword, so we actually could probably do this quite straightforwardly. I'm just worried that this glass is not as weatherproof as it claims. So maybe I should test this first. Just maybe. So I've now made two stacks of reinforced glass. But I have no idea where to build it. So I think I'm going to build it at spawn. And I first of all need to check if I can actually do this. Wait, better idea. Teleport back home. Get some cobblestone, and so we can pillar out, and then maybe get an angel block if we can't. So I'm thinking ahead. Now I'm thinking with portals. So then we go to spawn. Oh, and the FPS is stable here, which is good. And so let's... Can we place a block? Nope. how far out do we need to go? Oh, and I can't fly either. Okay. Why, how, what's the, okay, Z is going up here, and Y is 58. So if I, as long as I stay at Y58, or at least as close to Y58 as I could possibly get, and then go, 60, bonk. Oh, a bit too low, I'm at 55. I can place it down now, 55, 57, 58, good. So this will be our ground, and immediately smash it. That's not what I want to do. I want to break the block underneath and that one. Yep. And then can I? Yeah. Okay, I need more of a platform, and then I can just break it like. And can I can just I, yep, there we go, nailed it. Okay, so this can be our little landing strip. Maybe we could put some travel anchors down. I don't know how. I'd do it. Oh, I'll experiment anyway. Let's build this. And in my... Oh, I immediately made a mistake. is it so slow? Yeah, in my testing world, not only does this glass not smash, which is great, which is perfect. It is weatherproof. It does not blow up. So I'm going to do something like this. So it's going to be a too high entrance that we can get in, lay the soul sand down, which I realise I have not brought. Can we place torches on here? No, we cannot. So we need to put some sort of other block either side so we can get some light. Don't want it to be too dim. And we can lay out this like so. And we actually need it to be 3x3 on the inside and 4 high on the inside. So we can wrap it round like this. And I'm going to fill in the corners. I'm not entirely sure you need to, but I'll feel better in my for myself if I do. So even though it's more wither skulls used, it's probably worth it. So we can just build it up like so, and in fact we can use our wand. So it's currently 3 inside. We can do another layer, and now we can do another layer and add in the roof. And I'm hoping that nothing can spawn on this glass, because if we can't place torches on it, I think that means it's not a spawnable spot in general. But just in case, I can put a torch on the top. So what I also did in my testing world was have like a sneaky side entrance like this, because you will suffer explosion damage if you're too close. But I also don't want the wither to be wither able to fire at you, so to be able to see you. So if we do this, spawn it inside, run out to the side, this should be okay. Let's just build this out a little bit more. Oops. I realise this is getting a long-ish episode. I mean, longer. I was kind of hoping to aim for 22 minutes. I think it's going to be a bit longer. Mainly because we're still going to kill the wither. I'm determined to do that. Please tell me we have soul sand. Yes, we have some. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now let's get a skull. 1, 2, 3. And then we can go back to spawn. And yeah, I should probably see how far I can go. So yeah, I didn't like completely disorientate myself. How far can we go before we hit spawn protection? Because it would be really useful. Okay, I've not run out of cobblestone, but I can't place any more. So this is the end. That's the end of the spawn protection. And F7. Oh. Okay. Weird. Okay, that's the end of spawn protection. People can't jump that gap, but hopefully they'll be able to see that there's something out here, really obviously, and then they can all use it. So, and hopefully, like double hopefully, if the wither skeleton, if the wither escapes, it won't be able to destroy anything because this is spawn. But I'm going to get out of the way. And we're going to kill Aurelian! So there's this mod that renames all of the withers to either YouTubers or supporters of the mod. I'm not entirely sure. Maybe the same thing. And that torch is still there, but the lighting is gone. Okay, it's weird. So let's get its attention. I don't want to get shot though. So I'm going to cheese it. Cheese it hardcore cheese. This is the Wensleydale. Anyway, what's a hard cheese? Are you done? I don't know what a hard cheese is. I can't think of the top of my head. This is the hard cheese of the wither. But a crumb star? What the hell is that? What do you use that for? Biomash? I don't think I want to do that. Can you eat it? Maybe. I don't know if I can because I'm not hungry. But anyway, we've got 2 supremium essence, which is pretty sweet. Can we use that for anything just by itself? Don't think so. We could use 4 to make a supremium apple. Oh, we have to get the prerequisites for that. Yeah, no chance of that just yet. Diamond seeds. Yeah, this is the supremium is the top tier one. At least I'm pretty sure it can't make it into anything else. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Tier 5 mob chunk. It'd be good for spawners, I think. Or at least the essences. But anyway, we got the nether star. which is pretty sweet. And we can use that for a variety of things, but namely we can use it for void and resource miners, we can use it for nanobot beacons, we can use it for advanced wand cores. So we can get capturing wand, potion wands, oh that's it. This is it. The unbreakable wand. That's the one thing I did want to make just before we go. With our first and only Nether Star. Because I've been really bad at opening loot bags as well. It's another thing I keep meaning to do. Unbreakable wand! Yeah! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Sweet. So I'll put that away. I don't really know what that's for. But now we have like creative block placing. Well, not creative block placing, but a wand that doesn't break, so we can carry on placing the blocks as long as we have them. Which is very, very sweet. So, this has been LeSquatch. I shall say thank you very much for watching. Hope you guys have enjoyed. And see you in the next episode.